I will not return to the longhouse, Weto, never! And I won't blunt my teeth about it further!
But what are you so stubborn? The Rowatians do us a great favor and you spit in their faces! What do you need? Not at all, not at all. My sister and I are just having a small disagreement.
It is because you speak like this that I yell at you in the first place. You're beginning to sound like those Rowatian outlanders, and it shames me to say so.
Ignore her. She has an urchin up her ass about her cousins from the north and can't be persuaded. I should know. I've tried.
Is it so unreasonable to want to protect my culture, our culture, from our greedy neighbors? They arrive in ships laden with goods they believe will please us and think that gives them the right to build their walls on our land. Then they act surprised when we don't all fall at their feet with cries of gratitude.
Akira, don't encourage her. I will never hear the end.
We are no strangers to the menaces of the Deadfire. Pirates, colonials, Nagati's children. We have bested all of them before. We don't need them or their walls to keep us safe, and we surely don't need their longhouse. Another of the Rowatians' tricks. When our huts were destroyed in the storms, they did not rebuild them like they were as we requested. They built this longhouse instead. Are you not one people? They said. Why do you live divided, each cast apart from the others? They believe they know what's best for us, but how we live is not their business. The Fleetmaster says we are weak because we don't work as one. She doesn't see that it's our differences that make the Huana strong. She doesn't want to see it, lest it put the lie to their enterprise here.
We are no strangers to storms, but last year we suffered many powerful ones in quick succession, and our harvest of Kawiki fruit was destroyed. Price share was rationed, famine loomed, and then the Rowatians sent ships. Load after load of food, enough to see us to the next harvest. They could have left us to die, but they didn't.
It was only a ploy to make us dependent on them, Akira. We took their food and helping hands, and now we sleep in their buildings and watch the sea from their walls. Under whose banner? Rowatai's? Then we cease to be Huana as surely as if they conquered us.
We have the land and resources Rowatai needs, and they have the military might we lack. We share a common ancestor. Why not create a common culture? Together we would be strong.
I say, if you truly believe that, then you're a bigger fool than I thought. Akira, I don't need you to tell me as much. But I appreciate your support nonetheless. It is gratifying to be heard and understood. That an outlander could do this and my brother could not shames us both.
Caught between the Valians and the Rowatians, we will be crushed. We need a strong ally to survive the coming years.
I hate to see Tippa and Weto fight.
What do you need?
God even hear my prayers over all this noise?
On it.
Those Raparu dare make such a racket in my longhouse! What were those royal Deadfire fools thinking? I don't need a better house. I need privacy. What do you want? Not even the greatest Mataru can stand against a fleet of Rauatian warships. I am Mataru, a warrior. The best quarters are mine by right. And yet I cannot display my most precious possession, my grandmother's warhammer, for fear the Raparu might steal it. It is absurd. They know no better. A Juana soul is not born into the Raparu without reason, after all.
Over, then under, then twist. Good.
Ikira, it looks so easy when you do it.
Oh, hello. Come to watch me tie rugs, have you?
Asaru, he has been teaching me.
What say, traveler?
It's not a skill one learns in an afternoon. But should you wish to spend many months here in this longhouse, you're welcome.
I say, we have the room. So long as you do not mind sleeping like so many scrolls stuffed in a shelf.
It is as you say, but I have always admired the beautiful rugs Osaru makes.
And Nadunga can fix anything. Is it not reasonable we should learn from each other?
Akira, especially if we must suffer Waturi together.
Just so.
It's not so bad, excepting the night Waturi gets into the palm wine.
Ikira, but that man does snore loud enough to call down the rains. There is hardly any space to tie my rugs, to be certain, and I haven't had a moment to myself in weeks.
But there are also new friends to be made. Carry the winds with you, traveler. I've got it. enemies ahead. Enemies ahead.
Watch it with that. Will do. Sure. Enemies ahead. Got it.
I thought we were friends.
I bring your aid.
Lavaru beyond seek.
Ixi Alna.
That must have hurt.
My wheelhouse, friend.
I've got it.
Your every step fouls the ground. Why do you pollute this sacred place? The Rawatayan invaders trespassed upon our sacred ground and ignored our overtures. The fault for this conflict lies not with us.
Why should we believe you are any different? Eloquent though your words may be, they will build no peace between us and the invaders. They or we must leave this island, and we shall not be moved. Leave this place, Watcher, and do not return lest you wish to meet an early end.
The time to gawk has passed. Kill the trespasser!
Thank you.
Let's go.
Me and you are about to mix. No one noticed that, right?
What can I do you for?
Right.
No doubt the druids plot their next attack even as we speak. Excellent. You are as dependable as I've been told to expect. Now we can begin logging in earnest. Regarding your reward, we seized a cache of weapons from a gang of pirates we caught sniffing about Sayuka. Of course, we only use regulation weaponry here, so I'd appreciate it if you'd take these off my hands before one of my engineers does something foolish with them. You found me with a rare spare moment. How fares Onikaza's leash, Watcher? Do you have length yet, or does she keep you close at heel? You found me with a rare spare moment.
Stay out of the way.
You're making a mess of my schematics.
Thank you.
a land-loving bag of bilge bile. You owe me 400 pounds, a ship, and your cog swabbing life.
Good, I say.
will do. Found something.
Didn't work.
Sure.
There's a wallaby.
Mo, Ixi,
try something else.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. On it.
I see trouble.
Sure.
Didn't work.
got it.
Belzeto. What an extraordinary machine. It is a shame this has been hidden here for all this time.
No. No! I watched you die, crushed under that castle! Your monument to hubris.
Hey, it's our little skull! We thought we'd lost you. You've grown so much. A whole body now.
Silence! I've suffered several lifetimes worth of your inane babble already. Again you interrupt my plans, and again I am forced to compensate. My days of bouncing in your shadow or being jostled amongst spears and daggers are over. This is the end of our sordid companionship.
Let's not fight. We just want our little skull back. The rest you can keep.
You will keep your hands away from me, cur. Whatever beginner's luck won you the day at Cragholt has expired. Fate brought us here to correct its error. One such offense was inexcusable. Your very presence, an abomination.
Rather cocky for a man with no skin.
Then I'll borrow some of yours. Describe a spell that shrinks ears. Few things delight me more than slamming the proffered door on the Usher's hand. If the Circle sent you to interrupt my research, I'll fashion a scarecrow of your remains to deter their next hapless victim. I'm sure that pig-headed Commander Balerin is having a chuckle over the irony from whichever spoke of the great wheel he calls home. The Bannermen are loyal to a full purse, and my investments have paid off over several lifetimes. I had planned on taking vengeance by leveling your castle, but that sea-striding Ardra buffoon stole the opportunity out from under me. From there, it was the trivial work of dragging myself across the Deerwood toward a dock. One mouthful of soil at a time. Then, I arrived in the Deadfire as any simpleton would, by boat. All a matter of perspective. The same thing, perhaps. But the Circle wants only knowledge. I desire the power it represents. They are fools to delude themselves into thinking they want otherwise. That arcane upstart Bekana might not have been as unhinged as we once assumed. The Circle discounted her theories about a deep well of power in the Deadfire. All that changed when I felt its pulse. Your presence tells me that the Circle has felt it too. How astute. Now, if you're finished dissecting my academic setbacks, I am a rather busy lich.
This is futile! Try again. This is futile!
Dauntless Valian, doing so well.
not very helpful.
Feeling the strain.
Let's go. That must hurt. Supposed to happen.
Need some help here.
Isn't doing the job.
Nobody saw that.
Ah!
what remains of your soul.
Nope.
This indignity will not go unanswered. This cannot last, you know.
Will do.
Like you could use some fresh air.
I've got it.
If I don't survive our adventures, promise me you'll burn all my books.